is Orlando Cabrales Segovia. I'm the regional coordinator for Latin America and the Caribbean. Well, the energy priorities from the supply side are developing the resources in Argentina, the Vaca Muerta formation in Argentina, which has a huge potential to supply not only to the region, but to the world. The other priority from a supply perspective is to develop the gas reserves in the pre-salt in Brazil. That is an additional, very important supply from the region. And eventually developing other resources that are in countries like Guyana, which had recent discoveries, major discoveries in the last couple of years. So that is basically from the supply side. And in addition to that, to develop the infrastructure to receive LNG from the international market. That is from a supply side. And from the demand side, we have to grow our demand according to the forecast going forward. The growth in demand is 2% by year. We have huge opportunities in countries like, for example, Chile, to grow demand in Chile in transportation, to use natural gas to back up the power generation system with natural gas and phasing out coal. We also have an amazing opportunities in industry and other sectors of the demand. That is the second part of the challenges in the region. There is one additional thing which is not unique of Latin America, is the air quality issues, problems that we have in the different capitals and major cities around the region. So air quality is a major issue in the region. And one of the things how to address that and to tackle those problems, environmental problems, is by using natural gas. So not only electric mobility could be a solution for the region, but also and mainly natural gas in transportation. So that is there is a challenge as well. In Bogota, we had a major bid round where natural gas won most part of the renovation of the public system in Bogota. We are expecting to do that in other cities in Latin America, for example, in Buenos Aires, in Santiago. There is an additional component of natural gas, and the benefits that provide natural gas is accessing poor people, you know, and improving the quality conditions and the quality of life of poor people. Natural gas is affordable, is flexible, and it changes in a significant manner the quality of life of poor people. We have experienced that in Colombia. In Colombia, we have a coverage of almost 70%, more than 9 million end users in the country, families, and 80% of those end users are low-income and poor families around the country. So, and you can feel how that changes lives in these communities. Absolutely. I mean, it creates a better quality of life. I mean, they change using biomass or coal for cooking and heating, and they change to natural gas. There is a huge advantage there. There is a health advantage by using natural gas and not coal or biomass. And there is, of course, an important element in the economic development of the country as a whole. Not only the improvement in quality of life for communities and households, but also for the industry. I mean, natural gas is an important component in developing the industry around the region.